In this lesson, we are understanding what is blockchain and how it works. Okay, first, blockchain technology is a new technology or old technology? Answer is, it is a old technology, recently became popular. See, in the year of 1991, there are two people, Scott and Haber. These two persons have developed a first white paper on blockchain technology. They have released a first white paper. On blockchain technology. In this white paper, they have explained what is blockchain, what are the characteristics about the blockchain, how it works, what are the rules, this type of things, everything explained in this block, in this particular first white paper. So later, in 2009, Satoshi Nakamoto. This person has implemented the blockchain technology. The first implementation of the blockchain is Bitcoin. What is that? Bitcoin. So what is the difference between blockchain and Bitcoin? Is it same? No, it is not same. It is different. But the relative words. So you can say, based on the blockchain technology, Bitcoin is implemented or Bitcoin is developed. Bitcoin is developed based on the blockchain. So the blockchain is a technology behind the Bitcoin. That means what? You can create your own Bitcoin also based on the blockchain. Okay. After 2009, that n number of hundreds of implementations have been done on the blockchain technology. After that, the important milestone is in 2015, the next generation blockchain has been implemented by Vitalik Buterin. This person has implemented the Ethereum. So this Ethereum is developed by Vitalik Buterin in the year of 2015. It became very popular. In between this Bitcoin and Ethereum, hundreds of implementations done, but all those are not that much popular, are not that much different than Bitcoin. Those are very similar to Bitcoin. The new trendsetter is Ethereum. I will explain the difference between Bitcoin, Ethereum later in the further lessons. The next one, in 2017, IBM Corporation, International Business Machine Corporation, has implemented Hyperledger technology. Okay, so what I can say, this Bitcoin, Ethereum, Hyperledger, all these are the different implementations of which technology? Blockchain technology. So the blockchain technology is a technology which is behind Bitcoin, Ethereum, Hyperledger. In future, few more may come. N number of implementations can be created based on which one? The blockchain. First, the question is, what is blockchain and how it works? And why we have to go for the blockchain? This type of questions we have. Now let us try to answer, what is blockchain exactly? So what is blockchain here? The blockchain is a collection of blocks secured and connected by using cryptography, and which can be extended up to any level, any size, and which is distributed automatically over the P2P network. Here you can find the different words. But don't worry, I will explain about each and every word in detail. The first general comparison with the real world is, first, for example, I just came into the classroom. I am the first person entered in the classroom. So, I am the first block. Blockchain, I said, it's a collection of blocks. Okay, I am the first block. I just came here. I am standalone person. I am not dependent on any other person. I just came myself. Next, the second person followed me. Somebody asked him, why you come? Because of I came first. Suppose my name A, his B. Somebody asking B that why you come? B answers that because of A coming, based on the reference of A, same like that, based on the reference of B, C comes into picture. Based on the reference of C, D comes into picture. And the chain extends. Chain. So here what you can say, this is one block. This is the independent block, which is also called as genesis block. And second block follows the previous block. So this is the block number 0, this is a block number 1. Block number 1 has a reference to the block number 0. And based on that, one more block is created. Block number 2 works based on block number 1. Like this, n number of blocks you are able to create. But every block contains some data in the form of hash. What is the meaning of hash? We have to understand. To understand the meaning of hash, first we have to understand about the number systems. I think you already aware of number systems or don't aware of. Just try to recollect the number systems. Majorly we have three types of number systems which are most important. Decimal number system, binary number system, hexadecimal number system. There is one more called as octal number system that is not that much important for this situation. So which are three important? Decimal number system, binary number system, hexadecimal number system. Based on the number systems only, we can understand hash. Based on the hash format only, we can store the data inside the block. As of now, the blocks are empty. We have to store the data in the form of hash. To understand the hash, we have to require the number systems knowledge. Okay, try to recollect this. Right, here we have binary number system. Binary number system contains zeros and ones. Only two symbols it contains. Zeros and ones. 0, 1. And decimal number system. Decimal number system contains totally 10 symbols. 0 to 9. Okay, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Totally 10 symbols available. 0 to 9. And also we have one more important, which is exactly we require in the blockchain perspective, that is hexadecimal. Hexadecimal number system is important for the blockchain because it is used in development of hash. Listen, hexa means 6, decimal means 10. 6 plus 10, totally 16 symbols available in the hexadecimal number system. That is, as usual, 0 to 9, just like decimal. As a continuation of this, we have A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D, E, F also. 10 decimals, at the same time, 6 alphabets. Totally, 16 symbols available in the hexadecimal format. Okay, so why this discussion comes into picture right now? Because the hash will be always in the form of hexadecimal number, not in the binary or decimal. So what is the meaning of hash? We have to understand first. Hashing means I will give some data. That data can be anything. Suppose it can be some message like hello. It can be a number. It can be a file. It can be some audio file or video file. It can be a Word document or PowerPoint file. It can be some accounts of a company. It can be anything. Anything is represented as data here. The data can be given to the process called hashing. The process of hashing will convert the data into a fixed format, a specific format. What is the specific format? Listen. So hashing is a process, or you can say function. This hashing function will convert your any type of data. It can be some simple value to large value. It can be number or string. It can be a Word document. It can be a PowerPoint file. It can be Excel file. It can be a photo. Anything can be converted into a format called hash format. So if you ask what this hash exactly contains, hash contains hexadecimal number. How many symbols does it contain? 64 symbols. Actually, the 64, the number may be vary because it depends on which algorithm we have used for the hashing. I am assuming, I am talking about SHA-256 algorithm, one of the most popular, one of the best algorithms as of now available is SHA-256. There are some other alternatives also, RSA algorithm, like this we have different alternatives. I will explain about that later. MD5, SHA, SHA-1, SHA-256, like this we have different options. Anyway, try to assume the algorithm that we are using, the hashing algorithm, is SHA-256, based on which you are able to convert any data of any size can be converted into one hash that is having a fixed set of symbols, that is 64 symbols. But these 64 symbols will be equal to any one of these only. For example, what I can say, I will give you decimal number system, that is 0 to 9. We can write any large number, for example 100 you can write. This 100 includes these particular symbols. Based on that we can write some large number. You can keep on writing any large number, right? This small or large number includes any symbols that are included in the decimal number system, just like that. The 64 symbols, the 64 symbols numerical value will be inclusive of any of these symbols. Total available symbols are 16. But based on the 16, you can write totally 64 symbols. Right. So, why we have to convert into hash? We can store the data as it is in the blockchain. Why we have to convert? Because mainly for confidentiality. Confidentiality is a main goal of hashing. Because if you store this data as it is inside this particular block, something like hello, what happens? Any other person, any other company that can access this particular blockchain can open and read this particular information, may steal the data, my privacy is missing there. So instead of storing the data in a text format, in a understandable, in a readable format, instead of that, we can go for unreadable format. Such unreadable format is what? Hash. So the hash look like this. I will show one example of hash. Here is an example. We have just opened a website called anders.com/hash.html. In this particular site, if you can open, we are using which algorithm? SHA-256 hash algorithm. Here we can give any data. The same data will be converted into hash format based on this particular SHA-256 algorithm. So I'm just entering hello. This hello is now converted into this format. Unbelievably, this one is equal to hash. But we may type blah blah blah, lot of text we can keep typing. Any amount of data, unlimited data, will be just equal to a fixed set of symbols, that is 64 symbols in this one contain jacket. I'm just entering hello world. This hello world is equal to, you can see, A591 something, totally 64 symbols. Just for example, let's assume A591. So we have entered some data, something like, you know, hello world. That is converted into hello world. Hello world, that is converted into A59 something something. So what you can try to say, any data whatever you give can be equivalent to 64 symbolic hash. The hash is nothing but a hexadecimal number which contains 64 symbols. Okay, right. So the question is, why we have to convert? Answer is confidentiality, because if you store the data in a plain text format, other people can see your personal data. So the privacy and security will be missing. That's why we have to convert the data into a fixed number of symbols. And one more reason, if you keep storing the original data as it is in a original format itself, the size increases like anything. Suppose I'm giving some 10 MB picture or 1 GB video, something I have given. Even that 1 GB video also can be converted into this particular 64 symbols. 4 symbols is equal to 1 byte. So in that way you can say 64 symbols equal to 32 bytes. That 1 GB data is equal to 32 bytes. So the size of the data will be reduced. That is also one reason why we have to convert into hash format. So we should never store the data in a original format. We have to always store the data in the form of hash. So this is the hash of this particular hello world. But I'm going to store this hello world in the zero. Same way, the second block may contain some different data. It can be how are you? It can be some other data, whatever you like. So that is also converted into hash format. That hash also we are going to store here. So every block contains its own hash. The hash is nothing but which format? The hash is nothing but which format? Hexadecimal number. Data will be stored in the form of hash. Hash is in the form of hexadecimal number. 64 symbols, 32 bytes. Okay. So every block has its own hash. And how this connection can be happen? How this block number 1 is adjacent to the block number 0? How do you define the sequence? I told one example previously. First, I have entered into the classroom. I am not dependent on any other person. So I am the first person. I am the block number 0, which is also called as Genesis block. But the second person came based on the reference of me. The person B comes based on the reference of A. So B must store the address of A. So block number 1 should store the address of 0. So here we have to store hash of 0. Hash of 0. This is the hash of 1. But this is the reference to the previous block. This is hash number 0. This hash number 0 we have to store here. Now in the same way, this is hash number 2 itself. For reference of the connection between the 2 and 1, we should store the hash number 1 in this place. So can you guess what the block exactly contains? Two hashes it contains compulsory. Its own hash and the previous block hash. Suppose I am the first person, you are the second person. I am the person A, you are the person B. Now, the person B stored the reference of person A, but person A doesn't store the reference of person B. I don't know you, but you know me. That is what exactly the blockchain. This block number 0 don't know who is the block number 1, because the block number 1 address or reference is not stored here. But block number 1 knows the address of block number 0 because it contains the reference. Block number 2 contains the address of block number 1. Here address means the hash itself. There is no any memory address or something. Here address means the hash itself. And based on this, what you can say, there is one important feature, that is, we cannot change or break the blockchain. We cannot change the blockchain or break the blockchain. We cannot modify the blockchain. Why? What is the reason behind it? Listen, for every change of the data, we are getting a different hash. For example, if you just modify this L as a capital letter, entirely different hash we are getting. Instead of A being A59 something, we will get B72 something. You will get different hash. It's not like just one character changed, only one character will be different here. It's not like that. Completely different hash will be generated if you just even change single character. Even small space changed, dot is added. For small character change also, entirely different hash you will get. So if you change the hash here, the same hash only we are going to store here. So previously it was storing like, you know, A59 is a hash of 0 here. Now we have changed the L as a capital letter. So we got B72 as a hash here. So this one becomes B72. So this one is cancelled. Now we have changed it as which one? B72. And what is the address stored here? It has stored which one? A59, previous hash only available here. So this connection has been lost here. Either we have to modify this one here, we have to modify this one, B72. Since this block has been changed, we have to change the hash address of second one, again hash address of third one. So what you can say, if you change one block, all the subsequent blocks compulsory we have to change. If you don't change, the connection will be cut. The blockchain continuity, the connection will be, the sequence will be cut. Because if you change the block number 0 hash, since the block number 0 has already stored in the block number 1, that also we have to change. As we change this particular hash, overall this block number 1 hash changes, and that is already stored in the block number 2. This also we have to change. As if you change this one, this block number 2 hash will be changed. Block number 2 hash changed means we have to reflect the same thing in the block number 3, block number 4, and so on. So if you modify one previous block, the next block affects. The next block, the connection will be cut by default. And if you want to continue the sequence, we have to modify the remaining blocks also, then only possible. Suppose think about 100 blocks stored here. If you modify 56th block, all remaining blocks starting from 56 onwards up to 100, all the remaining blocks connection will be cut, and all the remaining blocks we have to modify, that is not accepted by the network. That's why blockchain is assumed as a read-only data. We can store unlimited data in the form of security format. Privacy fully available here, because we are not going to store the plain text format. We are going to store hash format. So it is 100% secured. At the same time, 100% read-only. Nobody can tamper my data. My data is safe on the network, even though that is available to everyone. So this is the feature of the hash.